It's from yesteryear. Are at the Disney Drive-In, Saturdays at 1:30 p.m., 12:30 Central.
Next, there's plenty of great family entertainment ahead, right here on the Disney Channel. Welcome to Walt Disney World Inside Out. The weekly show that keeps you up to date and takes you behind the scenes at Walt Disney World. With your hosts, Brian Leary, George Foreman, and J.D. Roth. Coming to you this week from the Magic Kingdom at Walt Disney World in Florida, please welcome J.D. Roth and Brian Leary.
Hello.
Hi, I'm Brian Leary.
And I'm J.D. Roth. Welcome to Inside Out. This is the show that takes you backstage at Walt Disney World in Florida.
Oh, and once a month in Disneyland in Southern California.
Yep, we show you the amazing behind-the-scenes stuff you never get to see even if you're a guest here.
You know, J.D., I got up this morning and I jumped out of bed and I thought...
You know, somehow I don't see you as the jumping out of bed type, Ruth.
Okay, so I got out of bed, threw the alarm clock out the window, and dragged my sorry little behind across the room. And
that's more like it.
I said to myself, not enough just to do a show. You have people from all over the world here, and you've got to make it a big show with a boffo kind of finish.
Boffo.
I love to say boffo.
Okay.
So, I'm looking over the space shuttle schedule that I keep with me at all times, and guess what?
No way.
Yep, there's a space launch this afternoon. Unbelievable, isn't it? And since Cape Canaveral is so close, we'll be able to watch the launch from right here. Yeah.
Oh, Brian, that has got boffo finish written all over it. But wait, there's more.
No.
If you call now, we'll include absolutely free at no extra cost a visit with our special co-host, the champ, George Foreman, in George's Corner.
It's a Small World could be one of the best known, best loved songs there is. There must be some way to get this tune out of my head.
Okay, so there's two ways to find the future. You can sit and wait for it to come to you.
Or you can go to Epcot's interventions like I'm gonna do right now. Interventions isn't some far-fetched look at how things might be hundreds of years from now. It's a display of the technology that's just around the corner. A place to play with the toys that'll be speeding us down the high-tech superhighway in the coming months. Let's take a look at what's going on this week. So what does it take to make a house a home? A little bit of love and a whole lot of technology. Watch this. Say it's nighttime. Ah, you gotta love that. And somebody is creeping a little bit too close to your bedroom window. A light will come on, and then check this out.
Move away from the house. Repeat, move away now.
Ooh, scary. Whoa. You hear that, dog? The homes of the future are going to be very secure. Let's go inside because us in the hosting business, we're not really scared of a dog. Come on. You guys at home are going to think this is totally cool. It's called the Butler in a Box. Watch this. Hello, Butler.
How can I help you?
Good morning.
Good morning to you.
Why don't we turn on the lights, Butler? Maybe, I don't know, open up the drapes, turn on the television. Yeah, and I'm getting a little warm. Maybe we should get those fans going. It's good to be the king. Okay, it's breakfast time. Breakfast Express. You set it the night before, and when you wake up in the morning, at exactly the right time. It's got your eggs. Whoa, it's hot. It's got your eggs cooked just the way you like them. has your coffee and some toast. And the technology of the future is always there when you need it. Say you left a few things on at home, you just call your butler in a box. Hello, butler.
How can I help you?
Can you turn off the fan, the television, and the lights? Oh, and by the way, can you have a steak medium rare for me when I get home?
As you wish.
Great. Not bad, huh?
We're heading over to the Disney MGM Studios for a special appearance by the cast of America's number one movie.
Hello?
Oh, yeah.
What kid hasn't dreamed of having his toys come to life? Well, in the Disney movie Toy Story, it really happened.
Oh, okay. Who else?
You're mocking me, aren't you?
But here at Walt Disney World, they come to life twice a day. The Toy Story Parade is coming our way.
That's right, boys. Hit the street and keep moving. I want you to cover every corner of this place. Hold your line and follow your squad leader. It's a jungle out there. I want you to make sure these tourists are having a good time. The success of this entire parade depends upon it. That's an order, men. Do I make myself clear? This ain't no glamour detail, and I am not your mama.
How do you turn a film like Toy Story into parade? I mean, it's got to be a momentous task.
We started out with many different approaches, but we ended up realizing that there was really no better way to realize this than in a parade here at Disney MGM Studios.
So you like being in the Toy Story parade, don't you, Sarge?
It makes my green plastic heart proud, I tell you, ma'am.
You think you're ever going to make Lieutenant, Sarge?
Golly, that's hard to say. It's all according to whether I can get these boys to dance good enough.
Troops ready to go, Sarge?
Troops are ready to go, sir!
In position. How about the rest of the parade?
Golly, I don't know about that because I'm physically incapable of turning back.
So good to see you.
Nice to see you, Buzz. Getting ready to get up on that spaceship?
Okay.
All right.
Yes, sir. Just the creation of Buzz is just phenomenal.
Well, that's extraordinary. He was very well realized. I mean, for our costume designers, I think it was an amazing achievement. It really looks like he walked right off the screen.
Oh, it's unbelievable.
It's always exciting to have something new to work on. I mean, we love, you know, realizing Mickey and Minnie and all the other classic characters in different ways. But to have a whole new set of characters, a whole new world to realize on the street in a parade was really a delight.
How thrilled are you with the actors that are playing the voices?
Isn't it the best? I'm so excited. And they were so great to work with.
Yeah.
They're really giving. For instance, Jim Varney, when we first got him in and recorded the voice, we actually had the design of Slinky Dog was a little different.
Really?
Yeah. His ears were up more and his eyes were wide open, and he was much more of a perky dog.
It sort of developed as it went along, and then when we actually saw it finished, it was amazing. We were amazed too, and heck, we were in it.
When you were creating this, did you find yourself sort of getting lost in the whole concept?
Very much so. What's great is not only is it technologically extraordinary, but it's great characters and it's a great story.
This week at the Magic Kingdom, Spectro Magic, everyone's favorite nighttime parade, returns for its nightly march down Main Street.
Golden Age of Hollywood is still alive at Disney MGM Studios. And just like the West Coast Hollywood, Disney MGM is filled with celebrities. Bette Midler, Tom Cruise, Harry Anderson, Kermit the Frog, and hundreds more have all left their mark on the screen and on the pavement outside the Chinese Theater. Among the Hollywood stars vacationing this week at the studios, it's Jay Thomas.
Hi, I'm Jay Thomas, and I'm here at the Disney MGM Studios in Orlando. And I'm not here as the actor you see on television and in the fabulous films that I've done. But I'm here as just a dad with a camera. And I'll do anything for a free room. Where are those kids? Where are those kids? Just pretend I'm your daddy just for a minute.
You ready to do that?
We'll do it right here. Your daddy. Now, we're here at the Voyage of the Little Mermaid, and my kids know all these songs by heart. And we all have the underwear. I mean, not just the kids. I have the underwear, too. Is this thing in focus? What is this? Where's my wife? You want to just pretend? Just for a second?
No.
Hi, how are you? My kids love ice cream. Could I have a little ice cream? No, Donald. No, seriously. Thank you. It's for my... Wait, would you hold the camera for a second, Donald? No, hold the camera. There you go. You know, the one thing I believe you should do is always, before your children eat anything, you should eat it first. There I am getting some souvenirs for my kids. They're going to absolutely love this. Oh, look at what it... Oh, this is... What are you... Oh, you carry something in this thing, right? You know, my kids don't have anything to carry, but I'll just get one for myself. You know what? They're all stuck together. I'll just get all of them, because I'm planning on having more kids. Do you have another one, another flavor? I'm not sure they'll like this flavor. Here, Donald, would you hold this for me, too? All right, don't drop the camera. The camera's on. Hold the camera in one hand and the ice cream in another. I'm sorry. They're so cute here, the characters, aren't they? Come to Daddy. Come to Daddy. What sort of cologne are you wearing? Now, look, you've had enough ice cream, okay? No more ice cream today, all right? Honey, put the camera down, would you? I don't want everybody to see this. Now, look, please, I'm on television. This is important to me. Do you understand? You know, a lot of people think that those of us that work and live in Hollywood have big egos. That's not true. I'm a family man. All right, one more ice cream. Now, wait a minute. Where are the Pocahontas shoes I bought you? What? Take these off. Well, we've been here at the Disney MGM Studios all day, me and all my kids, and I'll have this tape, you know, for the rest of my life. It's not like they're going to be kids forever. I'm sorry. Where are those kids? Kids, I'm about to cry about you, and you're not even here to see it. Kids? Kids? There he is. Harvey! Harvey, Daddy was about to cry, and you missed it. The great kid.
Flying over the Magic Kingdom in one of my favorite lands, Fantasyland, where you can take off on Dumbo the Elephant, go for a spin with Alice and the Mad Hatter, or soar to Neverland on Peter Pan's flight.
Just checking in on the space shuttle launch. Now, while we're waiting for that show, I got another show for you, The Legend of the Lion King. Let's go check it out. Come on.
A lot of people who see the show don't even know that they're live puppeteers. They think it might be an animatronic type of effect, but in truth, it's a live performance.
Well, when I'm king, that'll be the first thing to go.
I'm gonna be a mighty king, enemies beware.
Well, I've never seen a king or beast with quite so little hair.
I'm gonna be the main event like a king was before.
It's a very intense show, very physically exhausting, very demanding. You have to be on your feet, and I think that that's part of the charm to the experience because it's live.
Everybody look left, everybody look right, everywhere you look, I'm standing spotlight.
It's definitely a dance number for us. We go through 2 weeks of very intensive rehearsal, and during that time everybody finds out exactly where they go, and it's very, very complicated. And we do have times where everybody runs into each other, we have traffic jams, all sorts of fun things, but we usually work them out.
What's this control right here?
Okay, this is your mouth mechanism. It makes Simba's mouth move.
Hey, Simba.
There you go.
And what's the one all the way on the bottom?
Okay, this is your eye mechanism. It makes his eye blink. Like so.
Jeez, it's a lion! Run, Pumbaa! Move it!
Can we keep him?
Lions eat guys like us.
But he's so little.
Who's the brains in this outfit? My point exactly. You know, having a lion around might not be such a bad idea.
Timon is definitely an extrovert. He is a ham. Obviously, to the camera and in the show, he will take all the attention he can possibly get. And all the credit for everything, too.
Hey, this looks like a good spot to rustle up some grub.
Ew, what's that?
A grub. What's it look like?
Ew, gross.
Tastes like chicken.
Slimy yet satisfying. You'll learn to love them.
It works like a baseball team. There's 9 people doing the show.
and every person does a different puppet throughout the show.
Hakuna Matata! It means no worries!
So show me what, like, full action would be for you.
Full action?
So you're getting...
That's Pumbaa walking or running.
You're getting quite a workout then.
Oh, absolutely.
It's a problem-free philosophy. Hakuna Matata. Hakuna Matata.
So I guess you guys are the real talents here.
Hey.
Whoa, I think I hurt Pumbaa's feelings. Sorry.
Stop!
So you have to really create a team atmosphere, so because everyone's working together. When we saw puppets take five people to work.
Yes, and the performers, although they're underneath working these very difficult puppets, they have to be performing the show as well.
So their emotion down here where no one can see them transfers up into the puppet.
It's putting your soul into the puppet. And I must say that this group, we have hundreds of them. We do so many shows. And they're the greatest, most gifted group of puppeteers in the Magic Kingdom.
One of my favorite things about walking around Walt Disney World is that it's full of surprises. I mean, you could be heading down Main Street at the Magic Kingdom, and suddenly, boom!
We're the Rascals, and we're totally...
Inside Out!
Inside It's a Small World, they play that happy little ditty over and over and over again, even till those little adorable dolls are screaming their little heads off. You ever wonder how many times they play that song in a year? Well, guess what? That's today's question on Trivia Test Time. Okay, so let's see. Who knows the answer? Oh, you want it? Okay. 3 million, okay. How about you?
2 million.
Oh, not bad. Okay. We'll go for one more. Oh, hi, Sweetie. Okay, how many times do you think that song has been played in a year?
1.5 million.
So it's 1,500,000 times. Don't you just love that song? Yeah, right, okay. Well, one of you is gonna win a prize when we find out the answer from the champ, George Foreman, in George's Corner.
Now, this is what it's all about. Brotherhood all over the world. Little dolls singing their little wooden hearts out. Now, this is a happy place, right, kids?
Right!
Wow. Now, since this is their first trip, I volunteer to be their tour guide with the help of old Joe.
Hey. All right, now, it all started in 1964-65 World's Fair, where over 10 million children saw this ride.
Oh.
Our exhibit called It's a Small World is a salute to the United Nations Children's Fund, a worldwide organization that is working for a better tomorrow by helping the children of today. Our musical fantasy features the songs and dances of youngsters from more than 100 nations, each singing in his own native language.
Now, we have 553 audio animatronic dolls, along we have 32 channels of music that control over 400 actions.
How's all this done? Let's take a look backstage and find out.
This is one of my young ladies that I work on. And to keep it in sync with audio, we have different type of motors that we use so we can change the movement of the figure.
Now we're entering Asia, and if you look, you'll see the kids in their home dress.
We come out each morning at 3:45 in the morning, and we check each figure to make sure it looks its best. If it's been torn or worn or has had an oil leak on it, then we can go to backup wardrobe and change it out so that our guests have the best show possible each day.
I'd like to know about these peppermint sticks. Can I eat them?
No.
Oh, okay. Look at the dolls right on our left. Where are they from, kid? Can anyone guess?
India.
Now, who can tell me what these are right here, these animals here?
Penguins.
Now, if you look at the costumes, all the costumes come from their native homelands.
How grand skirts there. Where from?
They're from Hawaii.
Wow.
Now, this is our finale, where all the children from all the lands are represented in one room.
It's a small world after all. It's a small world after all. It's a small world after all.
It's a small world.
All right, kids, how did you like your first trip through It's a Small World?
It was cool.
Great, then. Be careful and watch your step. Now, here's the answer to our trivia test time quiz. How many times do they play It's a Small World in a year? 11 million. No wonder people go through life running around with that tune in their head.
Okay, there you have it. Now, who said 3 million? Okay, come on up. Come on up. What's your name?
Ashley.
And where are you from?
Pennsylvania.
Okay, so you said
3 million.
And you were really far off, weren't you?
Yes, I was.
So that's why you were the closest. So for being the winner on Trivia Test Time, we have this really great gift for you. And just in case you manage to get that happy little tune out of your head, listen. Hey.
This week, Sunday, January 7th, it's the third annual Walt Disney World Marathon. 26.2 challenging miles through the Magic Kingdom, Epcot, and the Disney MGM Studios. Later this month, IndyCar Racing roars into Walt Disney World on January 27th as they inaugurate the brand new track near the Magic Kingdom. Then, January 26th through February 25th, Chinese New Year's kicks off a month-long celebration at Epcot with special entertainment and authentic festivities. Later this season, February 15th, the American Film Institute showcase opens at the Disney MGM Studios with a display of props and sets from the hottest movies, plus an interactive area that teaches the art of movie making. Then, February 17th through the 20th, Mardi Gras hits Pleasure Island, featuring the most authentic New Orleans-style Mardi Gras this side of New Orleans, with festive costumes, decorations, and spicy Cajun food.
Whoops, gotta hurry, the shuttle's almost ready to go. Wait a minute, where's J.D.?
Hey, Bree, Brian, I'm up here. You should see the view. I can see for miles. It's awesome.
Can you believe this?
I'm up top spaceship Earth, watching a spaceship leaving Earth. Check it out.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Main engine start. 3 engines up and burning. 2, 1. Liftoff of Space Shuttle Discovery.
I'm stoked. Look at this.
Not only can't we top that, I'm not even going to try. Remember, we'll be back every week from Disney World in Florida or Disneyland in Southern California to take you inside out. So for J.D. Roth.
Good night, everybody.
And our co-host, George Foreman. I'm Brian Leary, and I'll see you next time.
Free copy of our vacation planning video and a complete calendar of Walt Disney World events, call us at 1-800-354-2500. Accommodations provided by Disney's Contemporary Resort.
Next Tuesday on an all-new Inside Out.
I think I'm going to be scared.
Yeah, you probably will be.
George Foreman versus his ultimate challenger, Big Thunder.
I'm not going.
Brian goes in search of adventure in the wild.
And there's so many ways to rush it here.
And she finds a wild adventure.
Everywhere you look is the beauty of nature.
And J.D. gets in the act.
Pucker up.
An all-new Inside Out next Tuesday.